Hello and welcome to a short update of my situation here. Today I was again in hospital. They changed again the bandage. There is a little bit reddish area around the artificial fingernail, so there seems to be a slight infection. They said it's nothing to worry about. There is no pain and so on. However, I should take the antibiotics a little bit longer, and they also did another paste on it. Salbe. Another tincture did with it. Yeah, they looked at this. They also marked the area where this reddish color was. I'm not sure if this was already there or not, yeah, because last time I told you it was very black and they cleaned it and we'll see. Yeah, they mark the surroundings, the area of this reddish area with a similar like my pants here. Yeah? And we will see if this is spreading or not. We'll squeeze the finger now and then poof, it's just, oh okay, it's just blood. It's blood is okay. If something else than blood, yeah, then it's a sign of a serious infection. So it was just spilling blood, so it was all right. And I also tried to find the workpiece. It's always a good idea if you have an accident or if an accident happens, also in the companies and so on, that you make an investigation why this happened and how to prevent this. I show you now what I tried to do anyway. I tried to do a thing like this. Okay, this is how it should have looked like. I made already a second one. Yeah? And what I now, this was last time, it looked like this. And what I tried to do was this groove here. This groove, you see, there is a groove. And here it worked a little bit. It's not deep enough for me, however, as you know, I did not finish. The reason is I want to have this drawer slide here inside so that I can place a table style thing and move it up. Then I have a movable shelf. Okay, this was the idea, yeah? To mount this here under my monitors that I can slide my graphic table in and out. Nice and easy for homeschooling, yeah, and looking convenient, and I slide it out and the right, I slide it in, and I can still use the space underneath. That was the idea. And here is still good. Yeah. And I think this part really looks quite nice. Yeah. And I tried to find the other part in my workshop. I did not succeed. Meanwhile, I know why, because it was not one part, it was meanwhile two parts, now three. No, it's still two. Yeah. It's a wonderful example of Kerbwirkung. Yeah. And also the glue of this is also exactly at this area. And you see also here, it was already the groove, yeah, and you see it's not yet finished. Yeah? See there, it was already finished, and here this was what I just tried to make. Yeah? And here you see already, it seems like it moved out here a little bit. You see here the signs of the tracks of the cutter. Yeah? And if I put this in this direction, you exactly see how the cutter was then chuck, pulling this thing away. Yeah? My fingers probably with this, because I moved this along the cutter. Yeah? And then it was flung out. And still feel it in the guts if I think about it. Yeah, it seems like this happened. And honestly, I do not know how to prevent this. So I will get rid of this machine. If I would have used the circle saw, just put it out a little bit on the table, put this there, yeah, and made not one cut, but several cuts, easy cheesy, it would have taken longer, and probably my fingers would still be intact. Yeah. So, this is my analysis of the accident. I will keep you posted. Stay safe.